I don't know if it happens here, but it happens in most countries where a lot of the young people are becoming disorientated, or they begin to find that it is not easy to memorize the Quran, because the minute they see the sheikh or the imam who is helping them to memorize the Quran, the first thing they see is a big stick, and the next thing they see is the stick being used to whack the children to be able to memorize the Quran. So they run away, and then they say, no, you must whack them, you must beat them. It's the Quran, it's the word of Allah, you must beat them for what? If they don't memorize it today, they will memorize it tomorrow. There are different ways of encouraging children. You don't need to beat. And then I heard one man say, well, if your teacher beats you, wherever the stick has struck, the fire of Jahannam will not touch. Where did you get that from? If that was the case, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum would be asking the messenger to beat them up completely from the top to the bottom. He taught so many people, they memorized the Quran. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had the graduates who graduated with the whole of Islam in their hearts. Do you know of a single hadith where he beat one of them because, hey, you don't know this verse, I beat you up? One of them? Even one? Not even one. So I'm saying this because we need to change the trend. We need to start employing different methods to encourage the children to memorize the Quran so that they look forward to it. Not by beating them up, no. But by giving them beautiful incentives, my beloved children. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for them. Really, I know when I memorized the Quran, I might have been amongst the category who also joined what we were saying here. May Allah make it easy, I don't want to say it again. But remember one thing, we need to know that is not the way we teach the Quran. The Quran is never taught by the stick. And I know of some people who say it's the only way you can get the kids to do things. No, if that's the case, we have failed. Really, because look at the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What did he say? Did he ever teach us to do that? The answer is no, never, not at all. So my brothers and sisters, I think it's about time we looked at it and we showed a keen interest.